Hi, this is Rick Telberg for CPA Trendlines. Today I have with me Isaac Keller from Trullion. Isaac, what does Trullion solve for?
Well, hey, Rick, thanks for having us. Trullion's creating a single source of truth for the accounting world. We're taking very, very complex accounting workflows and creating a real-time live data image of those workflows. We take unstructured data like PDFs and Excel, and we move them into financial reports so that accountants, CFOs, and their auditors can have one real-time image of their data.
One of the unique things about Trullion is that it's attractive to both auditors and controllers. Why is that, Isaac?
Well, we don't know. It was an accident. We originally built this for corporate controllers. My background is in corporate finance and accounting, and we built that workflow focused around emerging standards like revenue recognition and lease accounting, which were new, they were painful, they were complex. We built the workflow for corporate controllers. What was unique is we did two things. First, we extracted the data with machine learning using taking the PDF and actually identifying the transactions in the data in the document. The second thing we did is we actually did the workflows after that. So once we did that for controllers, we started to get a lot of interest from audit firms and advisory firms because they realized when you connect the unstructured data, like the documents and the Excel, into the entire workflow, all the way down to the journal entries and disclosure, you've connected the workflow in a streamlined way. And so that presented an opportunity to work with both sides of the ecosystem and bring them together into a single source of truth and one unified workflow.
What is it about lease accounting and RevRec that drives people so crazy they need Trullion?
Well, first of all, it's more difficult than the previous standard, right? So you have to identify more data from more sources and you have to do more complex accounting. For example, moving data onto the balance sheet creates a lot more work. Building a disclosure creates a lot more work. We're living in an era where it's sometimes hard to justify incremental work and incremental headcount for compliance exercises. On the audit side, you know, auditors already have so much to do and are starting to innovate and move away from sampling, but with new regulations, that's additional work they have to do and either pass off the cost to the client or figure out ways to innovate internally. So for us, by helping automate these lease accounting and revenue recognition workflows, it not only saves time and cost, but it even improves the accuracy.
How much time and cost does it save?
So it depends on the portfolio size. As you could imagine, revenue recognition is easy for some, hard for others. Leases might be hard for an asset-heavy company, easy for an asset-light company like software. In the end, we estimate it saves about 70% of the cost for an accounting team based on the amount of time that they spend on an ongoing basis staying compliant with these workflows.
70% of the entire audit or that facet of the audit?
Well, that's the calculation we've done for a corporate controller, so a corporate accounting team. I think that with the audit, it's yet to be determined. What's happening right now is the private companies are just now adopting the standards of revenue recognition and don't have to adopt it for future years with lease accounting. So we're still starting to see some of the benchmarks on the audit side. The other challenge is that every auditor does it differently. So if you sample, that may be a smaller exercise that you have to do. But if you start to, you know, if you start to increase the population and do 100% coverage, you're not just looking at time savings, you're looking at a more complete audit as well.
How many companies will be affected by these new accounting standards?
So in the U.S. with the private companies, more than 100,000 companies will be affected. Now, some of them are small and can become compliant in spreadsheets. Others will be heavily impacted and will need to think about automating the process or even purchasing modern automated software to complete the workflow on an ongoing basis.
Does Trullion work with other apps that may already be installed? Does it need to work with other apps that already are installed?
Yeah, absolutely. So if you're on anything from, you know, QuickBooks to NetSuite to Workday to Oracle to SAP to Microsoft, all of these major ERP players, we can interface with them. And then it can also work as a standalone if you prefer.
What do you see as the potential market size for Trullion's offering?
Well, I think it's the market size of the ERP. Right. So when you think about the ERP, let's put a number, $50 billion a year is spent on ERP software. And so what we're doing is we're building a modern system of record, single source of truth. We're doing it by unbundling the ERP into these workflows like leases and revenue and the future workflows that we're bringing out. That system, there's a very high cost of ownership. It's not just the money that you spend on software. It's the time it takes for CFOs and then auditors to reconcile all the data, all the spreadsheets, all the unstructured documents outside of that. So you've got the software spend, but then you also have a rising cost outside of it just to update and maintain these central systems.
Okay. Well, with that, Isaac Keller, Trullion, thank you very much.
Thank you, Rick.